We're not going to change course. We are going to continue. The content of the curriculum is very good. We are going to focus on implementation issues to make sure that it's smooth sailing in the implementation. We are going to do what is known as a process evaluation on the first year of implementation, see where we are having problems, and alter as needed. But we are not going to change course in terms of the meta issues related to the curriculum. We are not going to go back and say we don't want to do STEM. STEM, for example, we can't go back and say we don't want to promote entrepreneurship. We can't go back and say we don't want to promote critical thinking or problem solving. We don't want to go back and say we don't want to promote patriotism and a national identity among our learners. We want learners who come out proud to be about. So all those issues are not a matter of discussion. What is a matter of discussion is to say, this syllabus, for example, is it capturing exactly what we want? Is it allocating time properly? And those are issues that we're going to evaluate anyway through a process evaluation. But I'm going to make sure that we expedite that process.
So you're going to start soon, that process?
Yes. Before the end of the year, we'll have a team that will help us with that process evaluation program. Right. This is the resourcing that we're talking about. If it is going to work, it has to be resolved. So I'm going to, as much as possible, to be a producer, try to mobilize as much resources as possible in order to make sure that the implementation works well. I'm glad that there are a number of things that are taking place in our rural areas which are going to help us in the implementation of the new curriculum. The first one is the program by RIA to electrify all schools. The second one is the program that is being done by three companies, Tel1, Zanet, as well as e-learning solutions, to connect all our schools to the internet, so the connectivity aspect. We are going to face challenges as far as the devices, the computers, pads and other things like that. We're going to face challenges as far as that is concerned, but we'll make it our priority to raise resources so that we can resource the new curriculum. We are going to implement, prior to the beginning of next term, a $9 million program to provide teaching and learning materials. So we can't go back, so to speak, but we have to make sure that resources are there so that we can implement the new curriculum.